Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of MMOFTW here on MMORPG.com. I'm your host and managing editor, Bill Murphy, and this is the week that was in MMO News. Now we're going to go ahead and do this a little bit early this week because we're about to fly out to PAX and report on the show in Seattle, which is kind of the last major show of the year, except for, of course, BlizzCon, which happens in November. So I wanted to get this out because obviously I missed it last week like a bad captain. I forgot to steer the ship when I was going away for my friend's bachelor party. And so here we are this week with five of the top things that happened in MMO and RPG gaming. Let's get right to it with number one. The Witcher 3 has now officially sold through 6 million copies in 6 weeks. I know it's not an MMO. Yes, it is a single-player RPG, but that is just fantastic to hear. There are very few games that deserve the kind of success that Witcher 3 has experienced, and without any doubt, The Witcher 3 is one of those games. It is an absolute testament to how passion and care and attention to detail can make a stunning visual and audio and gameplay and just immersive RPG. And The Witcher 3 is, you know, it's proving that there is a rife market for these kind of hardcore, deep RPGs. And I don't think we're going to see any sign of the RPG revival slowing down anytime soon. So congrats to CD Projekt Red, and we can't wait to see what the expansions for The Witcher hold. And in Wildstar news, the development team over at Carbine detailed the new user experience this week on their official blog, which shows you how you'll not only have a quicker and easier way to get into the game if you're a veteran of MMOs, you don't have to do the Arkship stuff anymore, but if, say, you wanted to take a look at how the new revamped tutorial system works, you could start, while you're still in your actual cryo chamber and how you're getting awoken by the AI and then you're brought out and then you do a whole new Arkship experience. It's pretty cool stuff. You want to head over to the Wildstar site to see what the new user experience is all about as the game heads towards free-to-play in just probably a couple months now. And in Diablo 3 news, the new patch has finally dropped. It's got a brand new location and Kanai's Cube, which is like the Haradrim Cube. It's got a new way to handle the rifts and all that other stuff. And of course, with it brings a brand new season of gameplay for the ladder system with rewards and all that good stuff. So head on over to your Diablo game on Battle.net and download the patch and get started if you're all about grinding out those gears and figuring out how to use the Kanai's Cube to take some of the cool things and effects off of your old and useless legendaries and put them on some of your better ones. And in Kickstarter news, we actually just announced on Thursday, just published on Thursday, an article all about Mud from Pure Bang Games and Benjamin Walsh. This is an indie little MMO that mixes both the Minecraft-style voxel visuals with more of an artistic 3D modeled character visual style that is reminiscent of games like King's Quest and things like that. It is a survival-based MMO with PvP being a hardcore focus, as well as sandbox building and town building and a living, breathing world that will react to your and the other players' actions. If you kill all the sheep, the wolves will not have food, so they will start hunting down people. If you are harassing bandits all the time, chances are you're going to build up some infamy with those bandits, and then maybe they'll gang up and come take you out and take out your town that you've so preciously built up over time. Some pretty cool ideas with the Mud development. They expect to be in early access in March of 2016. The Kickstarter's just kind of a low amount of $65,000. If you are interested, you can head on over to MMORPG.com or click the link in the details below, and it'll take you to the article to read more about the game and to check out the Kickstarter. I think it's a pretty good one, especially knowing that Pure Bang and Benjamin Walsh are open to doing PvE servers, not just the whole hardcore PvP lose your loot kind of thing. And in some final good news for the week, Project Gorgon has been funded completely. Not only that, they have really gone through a lot of their stretch goals as well. Big congrats to those guys. We are all huge fans at MMORPG of what Project Gorgon is trying to do. It is mostly just a two-man team, but now with this Kickstarter, they're able to hire a lot more people and get some more artists working on the game, because if there's any one area where the game is sorely lacking, it's in the visuals department, and that will hopefully change now that they're able to hire some artists to help them round out things. And that'll do it for this week, folks. As I said, we're off to PAX Prime in Seattle tonight as I'm recording this, actually. I fly out in just a few hours. So I hope you all have a great weekend. Look for a lot of coverage from PAX Prime. And even some new games, I'm being told, are going to be announced. Hint, hint, wink, wink. So keep your eyes on the site Friday night at, say, 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 Pacific. That's it for me. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, Twitch, YouTube, and Facebook at MMORPGcom without the dot. And you can follow me on Twitter at TheBillMurphy. Have a good one, guys. And remember, don't let a bad pug get you down.